This is episode 5 of Financial Pop. Have you tried turning it off and back on again? If you haven't seen the British comedy, The IT Crowd, then let me introduce you a little bit to the two main characters, two of the three main characters, Roy and Moz. They're IT guys at a big company in England, and they don't feel like they get any respect. So let's take a look at a somewhat long clip, but well worth the time. And we'll learn a couple of different lessons from Roy and Moz at the end of it.
Hello, IT. Have you tried turning it off and on again? Oh, okay, well, the button on the side, is it glowing? Yeah, you need to turn it on. The button turns it on? Yeah. You do know how a button works, don't you? No, not on clothes.
Hello, IT. Yeah, huh? Have you tried forcing an unexpected reboot?
No, there you go. I just heard it come on. No, that's the music you hear when it comes on. No, that's the music you hear when... I'm sorry, are you from the past?
You see, the driver hooks a function by patching the system call table, so it's not safe to unload it unless another thread's about to jump in there and do its stuff, and you don't want to end up in the middle of invalid memory. Hello?
Oh, really? Well, why don't you come down here and make me then? Huh? What, you think I'm afraid of you? I'm not afraid of you! You can come down here any time and I'll be waiting for you. I told her. Oh, God, it's about time you got back. It's been all go.
You had a job?
Girl on fifth.
Did you and her hit it off?
Define hit it off?
Did she continue talking to you once you'd fixed her computer?
No. And while I was working on it, she rested a cop on my back.
No.
Yeah.
Unbelievable.
Yeah, I mean, they've no respect for us up there. No respect whatsoever. We're all just drudgeons to them.
Yes. If there were such a thing as a drudgeon, that is what we'd be to them.
It's like they're pally-wally when there's a problem with their printer, but once it's fixed...
They toss us away like yesterday's jam.
Yes! Yesterday's jam! That is what we are to them. Actually, you know what? That doesn't really work as a thing. Because, you know, jam lasts for ages. Hello, IT? Have you tried turning it off and on again?
Okay, lesson number one, customer service. If you're dealing with people, be good to them. Don't act like they're stupid. Don't make them feel bad for asking a question or not knowing something. Now maybe Roy was a little bit justified in his frustration with someone on the other end who obviously had no idea how to turn whatever it was on. But be patient, have better customer service. On the other end, we saw Moz, who was talking way above who he was speaking to. Know your audience, speak to them, help them out. Know what will benefit them more, and it will make your interactions with them much smoother. And the second lesson we can learn from Roy and Moz is try to find the simple solution first, or at least try the simple solution first. Kind of like Occam's razor. If there are multiple possible solutions to something, the simplest one is probably the right one. So let's start with the simplest. If we can fix it quickly by turning the machine off and turning it back on again, then maybe that will shorten our time to solve the problem, and it will help figure things out, help solve the issue. So remember, before you call for help, try turning it off and back on again, and be a little bit better customer service-wise with your clients or anyone you deal with. Now, the challenge for this episode is, when you have a problem, do what you can to solve the problem before going for help. So when I was practicing law, I was a member of a listserv regarding bankruptcy. I was always much more successful getting help with a question that I had and getting an answer when I had done a lot of the research on my own. And I was just going to those others who may have had more information than I did to confirm a question that I had. Or the answer that I had found. You're gonna get a lot further with most people when you do the same. So try the simple things. Do some troubleshooting on your own, and when you've done that, if you still haven't figured it out, go to the experts for help, and they will be happy to help you. And that's what I challenge you. I hope you enjoyed this episode, and I look forward to sharing more of my insights in the future. Thanks.